Hello friends, once again I am here and I am with the new lecture, and that lecture is on data types. In last lecture I told you up to the different data types and what is the size of each one and what is the logic behind taking the 2 bytes for character in Java. That is very very important feature of Java. And now today I am going to tell you that in which way you have to find out the minimum maximum value of any data type. So just I am switching the screen and I am coming to my board. Last time I told you all these things, just today I am going to tell you in which way you have to find out. Till now I told you integer will be taking 4 bytes, double will be taking 8 bytes, float will be taking 4 bytes, byte will be taking 1 byte. So in that way I told you the size of each one. But now the question is, I want to know what is the minimum value, what is the maximum value, but exactly I am not going to calculate the size of I am not going to calculate the minimum and maximum value of integer or double or float or byte. Today I will be telling only one method to find out, how to find out the minimum value of integer, maximum value of integer, minimum value of double or etc. Now before going in the detail, you have to understand one data type that is taking only one data type. That is taking only 2 bits. So how many discrete values can be represented by such 2 bits? So you can see 00 01 10 11. So total number of values, total number of values equal to 4, means 2 to the power n, and here n equal to 2, so 2 to the power 2 equal to 4. Now you can see what is the minimum value. What is the minimum value? It is 0. Now you can see what is the maximum value. It is 3. This is maximum value. Maximum value is 3. So now in which way I can find out the minimum value and maximum value by the same formula? Okay, you know the minimum value will be 1, minimum value will be 0, so it is okay. Now what will be the maximum value? So you can say maximum value, it will be equal to 2 to the power n minus 1. So it will be equal to 2 to the power 2 minus 1 equal to 4 minus 1 equal to 3. Now in the second example I will be considering one data type that is taking 3 bits. Data type taking 3 bits. So we will go from 000 to 111 and total discrete values will be 8. You can see. So how to find out by formula? 2 to the power n equal to 2 to the power 3 equal to 8. Because it's taking 3 bits this time. So I am putting 3 there. Okay, now what is the minimum value? This is minimum value equal to 0. What is maximum value? This will be max equal to 7. Okay, so now it is clear, total number of discrete values 8. You can understand minimum value will be 0 and maximum value will be 7. So exactly in the same way, now what you have to do or what we have to understand, that you have to see now this time data type. Data type taking 4 bits, or I can say size of data type is 4 bits. So now we will start from 000 and we will go up to 1111. So total values will be 16. How to find out total values? Equal to 2 to the power n equal to 2 to the power 4 equal to 16. Now minimum value 2 to the power, no, 2 to the power, it is 0. What is maximum value? Equal to 2 to the power n minus 1 equal to 2 to the power 4 minus 1 equal to 2 to the equal to, you can see here, 16 minus 1 equal to 15. So maximum value is 15, minimum value is 0, and total number of values are 16. So exactly in the same way, you have to apply this logic on each data type. And now for integer, if it is unsigned, integer taking 4 bytes, or just leave it, we are taking one example of byte, size equal to 8 bits, size is 8 bits, or you can say 1 byte. So minimum value will be 0, maximum value will be equal to 2 to the power 8 minus 1 equal to 255, and total values equal to 2 to the power 8 equal to 256. So total values will be 256. So this is the fundamental concept of finding the minimum, maximum and total number of values for any data type. Just you have to put the value of n. Okay, now if I am saying that for the case of sign, so I think this is okay. For the case of sign, we will be understanding that in the next video. And just I am switching my screen. So friends, today I told you how to calculate the minimum value, maximum value and total number of values for any data type. Just you have to put the value of n there, and really you will be finding very easily. Naturally, when we are raising the power of 2 more and more, then calculating and finding that is not very easy. So we can find out it by computer or by calculator, or just we have to memorize. But mostly, if you are talking about the double, you are talking about the float, and you are talking about the integer, then integer in Java, when integer is taking 4 bytes or 8 bytes, for long 8 bytes, for double 8 bytes, naturally finding the maximum and maximum value and total number of values will not be very, very easy, because we have to do lot of multiplication for that. So whatever is written in the book, we have to test on that. Sometime if we want to just verify that, then we can verify, but we have to do a lot of calculation for that. So we can leave it only with the power of 2, and we can find out minimum value, maximum value in power of 2 only. And but you have, main question is this, you have to understand the logic, what logic is applied behind the calculation of minimum, maximum and negative, positive values. So in my next lecture I will be telling you, if data type is signed, in which way we have to calculate minimum value for all the negative values and maximum value for all the negative values, what is the minimum value for all positive values, what is the maximum value, what is the minimum value for the all positive values. So in that way I have to go, and thank you once again, and you have to like my channel, subscribe my channel. I will be presenting very interesting topics on it, and not only from the books, as per my experience I will be telling lot of things to you, and really you will be enjoying and you will be benefited if you are joining my channel. So subscribe my channel and like my channel, share the videos. Thank you and thank you.